always serving a fresh cup of daily inspiration, Dianna Hobbs.
Today's inspiration is to remind you that God is still for you. Welcome to your Daily Cup of Inspiration podcast. I'm Dianna Hobbs, founder of Empowering Everyday Women Ministries, a 501c3 nonprofit organization that distributes free resources all around the world to help you grow in your faith and become all God has destined you to be. My heart is overjoyed that you've joined me again. I love, love, love sharing the gospel with you. I am coming to you live from Empowering Everyday Women Ministry Studios here in the city of Buffalo. And today I want to hop right into the podcast, but I want to remind you that each podcast you hear is available as a free resource. You can download the podcast. You may stream them online at DiannaHobbs.com, through iTunes, Google Play, Stitcher.com. You can visit my YouTube channel under Dianna Hobbs and hit that red subscribe button and turn on your notifications. And every time a podcast is uploaded, you'll be among the first to know. Let's begin with a prayer and then delve right into what thus saith the Lord. God, I just thank you so much for this opportunity to share your word with the individual listening. I pray right now that you would speak a word in season to them. They need to hear from you, God. Word my mouth, I move out of the way. Speak and we receive it in Jesus' name. Amen. My home team, the Buffalo Bills, is making national headlines today. I wish I could tell you it was for an amazing victory, but it's not. It's surrounding this decision. Our team's head coach, Sean McDermott, he decided to replace our starting quarterback, Tyrod Taylor, with the rookie backup quarterback, Nathan Peterman, for next week's game against the Chargers. Now, this decision came about after Tyrod Taylor had the worst game of his career last week. We lost 46-10 to the New Orleans Saints, and so it was announced today that Tyrod was going to be benched. I'm not sure about what his fate will be going forward, but this doesn't look good. And this is to the consternation of Tyrod's biggest fans. He has a major fan base. So the decision has caused a whole lot of debate among sports enthusiasts. Some agree with the choice, others disagree with it. I'm not much of a sports debater because I don't even know enough about the players, the stats, and the business of the game, so I won't offer up my uninformed opinion. Now, I do understand football, but beyond the basics, I don't know much. But still, plenty of people are going to bat for Tyrod. They're sticking up for him, fighting on his behalf, and decrying what they perceive as an injustice. Again, I don't get into all the sports talk, but what I will do is share what the benching of Tyrod Taylor did make me think about. Want to hear it? Here it goes. I considered how glad I am that God is not like man. He doesn't bench us, so to speak, or cast us aside or give up on us when we don't perform up to a certain standard. He is faithful. He loves us. He develops us and creates a loving environment that supports our growth and development so we can become everything he's destined us to be. Isn't that amazing? Aren't you glad that God loves you unconditionally? I know I am. He doesn't ask us to measure up to some particular standard so that we'll be worthy of his love. The world, on the other hand, does work that way. But thanks be to God that the ways of the world are not the ways of the kingdom. God was so gracious that he offered his son Jesus as a ransom for our sins because he knew that we could in no way measure up ever to the strict standards of his holiness. Because Jesus washed us whiter than snow with his blood, we're saved. We have been redeemed from sin. We have been bought with a price. We are now the righteousness of God. We are royalty, adopted into his family. We are heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ Jesus. We have an inheritance because Jesus is Lord of our lives. Isn't that good news? Listen, I know that God is on your side, and you've got to know it too. He's for you. He's not going to forsake you. He will not drop you. Even when man is against you, he yet fights for you. No matter what others say or think about you, he is on your side. He's still for you. As I was meditating on this, the Lord led me to an amazing example of his favor and the way he fights for his people in Exodus 14, a very common passage. And this is just where we see how God miraculously moved on Israel's behalf when they were pursued by Pharaoh's army while they were attempting to cross the Red Sea. Now, in Exodus 14:19, the Bible says that the angel of the Lord, as well as the same pillar of cloud that God had used to lead the Israelites through the wilderness that had been in front of them all that time, suddenly moved behind them as the enemy tried to sneak up the rear. Won't Satan try to sneak attack you? The Bible says once that cloud moved to the back of Israel, God, who controls the skies, did something amazing. He caused that cloud to cast extreme darkness over Pharaoh and his army so they couldn't see their way forward. God blinded the enemies so they couldn't get to his people. But that's not all God did with that cloud. Remarkably, as the cloud behind Israel darkened the view of Pharaoh and his army, on the side of it that was facing the direction of the Israelites, it emitted light and did just the opposite. It illuminated the way. Same cloud, different result. My, oh my, when God is for you, things work out differently for you, don't they? Someone who doesn't serve God would go through a similar situation and face terrible defeat. But when God is for you, when he's fighting for you, the outcome is different. The weapon is formed, but it won't prosper. The attack will come, but it won't work. If you're glad to know the Lord is for you, go ahead and slip up that hand and tell him thank you right there. I love, love, love this story in Exodus 14. It just gets me stirred up. It never gets old. See, many of us only focus on how when Moses stretched his rod and the sea parted. That's the part that we get excited over. But we overlook that simultaneous miracle, how God used a cloud to help Israel see as they walked across the Red Sea on dry land. First, he made the way. Then he guided them all the way while he made it impossible for the enemy's attack to prosper. As a Reverend used to say, who wouldn't serve a God like mine? Isn't he awesome? The Egyptians, whose hearts were hardened against God and his people, were blinded by the supernatural darkness of that cloud. When God got behind Israel, he put a separation between them and the enemy. The Egyptians who sought to attack them from behind were neutralized. Friend, God is on your side. He's stressing that for you. I know the enemy may be trying to viciously attack you, but he won't succeed. Satan might be attacking your finances, your family, your mind, your ministry, your health, your career, your business, your divine purpose, but God is with you. He is for you. In Isaiah 52:12, King James Version, God told his people, "For ye shall not go out with haste, nor go by flight, for the Lord will go before you, and the God of Israel will be your rear reward." I've told you on other occasions what rear reward in Hebrew means. In case you've never heard me explain it or you've forgotten, I'll share it again really quickly. Rear reward is a word that means rear guard, like the rear guard of an army, which defends and protects and prevents attacks from the rear. So God was saying, you don't have to run away from the enemy, be intimidated or fearful, because God has your back. He's your defense. He's your rear guard, your rear reward, protecting you from those sneak attacks, sustaining you when the enemy is pursuing you, and lighting your pathway so you can make it to your destination. Whatever you're facing right now, at this moment, God is still for you. I know I've been telling you, but say it, own it. Say, God is for me. There you go. It may seem like everything that could go wrong is going wrong right now, but he's still fighting for you. And I want to remind you that God is fighting the enemy on your behalf by stirring Exodus 14:14 in the New International Version right up into your cup of inspiration. And it says, the Lord will fight for you. You need only to be still. As you drink down the contents of your cup, place your hope, confidence, and trust in the Lord who defends you. Know that he's your present help in trouble. He is still for you. And remember, the attack the enemy had planned, it's not going to succeed. God has already blocked it and surrounded you with favor to move forward. Now let's pray. The enemy is attacking this, my sister, this, my brother, from every angle, but they are protected, blessed, and favored by you. Despite what it looks like right now, help them not to speak defeat, but to declare that no weapon formed against them shall prosper, because you are their help and you are still for them, no matter what it looks like right now. Thank you, Lord, for the victory that you have already secured on their behalf. We glorify you now in Jesus' name. Amen.
Your Daily Cup of Inspiration podcast has been brought to you by Empowering Everyday Women Ministry. Ministries, where we help fuel your faith every day. For more information, log on to www.deannahobbs.com.